it's nice to look around the room and see so many friendly faces that we know and love so well, but it's also great to see all those new people here. You've had lots of time to get to know one another. I hope you'll continue to do that throughout the conference. We encourage interaction. Please don't be shy. Catherine and I are available throughout the 2 days to help and guide you if you need that. But please feel free to chat to the people at your table, reach out to anybody else for help. This is, Mary's put this together in a fantastic way. It's such a community now. 10, 15 years ago, nobody knew who the other inventors were in the world. She actually brought the community into the light, out of the shadows, and has created a whole new infrastructure of the industry. So we really do need to thank her. So thank you for that earlier. That's great. My job, first job here this morning, is to introduce our first speaker. As you can see on the screen, it's Joanne from the Grommet. Interesting fact that we managed to elicit from her is that her great-grandmother was the first female motorcycle license holder in Massachusetts. So my follow-up question was, do you have a motorcycle license? And I'll let her answer that one. Joanne is the co-founder and the chief discovery officer of the Grommet. Hands up, those who know the Grommet. So their reach is pretty good. They curate and find new maker products and bring them out into the light. So you've got an interesting, fascinating 30-minute chat from her this morning. So I'd like to welcome to the stage Joanne.
Wow, what a wonderful vibe it is here this morning. I'm honored to be here to speak to you today. I do thank Mary, Brent, Catherine, Bill, the whole team here for bringing this group together. Honestly, ChiTAG is unique. I know of no other industry parallel that offers similar support and resources to help inventors get discovered. Of course, the tagline for the Grommet is discover what's next. And so product discovery is very near and dear to my heart. It is my understanding that, you know, some of the biggest toy brands, toy retailers, toy distributors, toy experts are going to be with us this weekend. And so take advantage of this kind of brain trust that's all around you today, this weekend. These people are coming here to be attached to the entrepreneurship that's in this room. That's why I'm here, to meet you. So take advantage of it. Don't be shy. Okay, so let's not turn that on again. I'd like to have a show of hands here. Who in this room would consider themselves an inventor or somebody who's come here to be discovered? Great. And on the other side, who's here to discover the next big products? You might be a big toy brand or a distributor or somebody like the Grommet. I have two hands up. We're here to meet you. So hats off to this team over here for bringing us all together. This is a really special day. My plan for this morning is to tell you a little bit about the Grommet's business journey. I hope you can find some parallels to your business journey, and maybe you'll learn some lessons that we kind of learned the hard way. We are a product launch platform for innovative products, new to market products too. We work in 16 different consumer categories. We cover consumer tech and pet products and housewares and hardware. We cover beauty and fitness and toys and about 10 other categories. Our business model is e-commerce. That's how we sustain our business. But we do much more than provide a buy button and a listing on a digital page. You should think of us as a media company, a marketing company, and a retail partner devoted to shining a spotlight on your product. This video that I'm going to show you next, and has already kind of run for a second, does a nice job of explaining who we are. So I'll show you that now.
This is a Grommet. This is a Grommet too. And this is the Grommet. There are millions of products online, but you want the best for your friends, your family, and yourself. Maybe it's a gift they've never seen before, or a product that solves a common, everyday problem. Well, they're being made every day by people just like you, in garages and studios and workshops from all around the world. They're small businesses with big ideas. And at the Grommet, we're discovering and shining a spotlight on these innovative products so you know they exist. Maybe it's a NASA-grade screen cleaner, a portable pizza oven, a Bluetooth guitar, or an egg that will replace your laundry detergent for a year. It's easier than ever for people to bring an amazing idea to life. And when they do, we'll be waiting to tell you all about them every day. And that's the Grommet.
And so you might think that that video is speaking to you, but it's not. That is speaking to the people that come to the Grommet to support you. These are the customers that we have assembled at the Grommet who are supportive of entrepreneurship, they're supportive of small business, they're supportive of discovering what's next. They're curious consumers, and so we're pretty proud of the kind of community that we've created to support innovation and the inventor community. A couple of stats on our business. We've been around for about 11 years. For four of them, nobody knew us. We barely survived. In 2012, a wonderful Japanese company took an investment in our business, and we were able to expand and grow. In 2014, we launched a wholesale division. We clamped on a B2B business to support makers. We call inventors makers in our community, in our business, to support makers and represent them to small retailers across the country. In 2017, Ace Hardware took a majority stake in our business, and we're now flowing innovative, interesting, differentiated products to Ace, who have 5,000 stores. Over our lifetime, we've launched 3,000 new-to-market products. We have assembled 6,000 retail customers, mostly small independent retailers on Main Street. This is an underserved population, and they use our platform to discover products in an effective, efficient, low-cost way and buy them all in one fell swoop. And our NPS score, that's a measure of how much people like us, is 79. That's a good score. Your cable company is has a negative score. But that's kind of the major stats of our business. And these are some of the powerful products that have been launched by Grommet over time. A lot of these were in our early days. It's a long road to this kind of success. But yes, we launched Fitbit in 2009. We launched the green cleaning company Mrs. Myers when it was still Mrs. Myers and not Kildrea. We worked with Simply Safe and OtterBox when Kurt Richardson was working out of his garage. He's now the chairman of LifeProof, and many other products that we're quite proud of. So, you know, when you start a business, you have to kind of have some insight around why you are doing this. It's not easy. Mary called it, I don't remember the word that you use, but I call it you need to be incredibly tenacious to grow in a business that's successful. And why is that? Because it is a long, hard road. It's a wonderful road, but it is hard. And so the Grommet was, again, founded to help solve some of those success problems. And we do focus on innovative products. Innovative products are hard to get market adoption as is, but innovative products coming from independent entrepreneurs are even harder to get to find success. And one of the founding insights in our business was that the reason that innovative products often fail is because they are inherently more difficult to understand. And we set out to create a media platform to decode innovative products. Listen, I was, in my prior life, I was the vice president of product development for big sneaker company, Keds. And I learned this about this problem there. My job was to expand the product line. My job was to keep it fresh. My job was to reduce the dependency on the kind of foundational products that were historical and ready the company for tomorrow. And yet, there was so much control over a handful of very powerful buyers. And even internally, your sales force would cast a disinterested eye, and all of that innovation would be wiped right off the table in a second. And that made me mad. So the reason that we created the Grommet was to use technology, a media platform for product understanding, a small contained story about the invention, the entrepreneur, and then we would cast it out to communities across the web and draw people overnight. It's like digital word of mouth. Draw people to the Grommet to learn more about these products. And in a nutshell, that is what we still do 11 years later. We create stories about humans doing great things. We cast these stories out across the web, and we draw people to our platform to explore all the wonderful innovation and creation that is happening in 16 different product categories. So our mission is simple, and it's one I think that everybody in this world can embrace. I'm certainly proud to be the founder of a company that represents so much good, but our mission is to help innovative small business succeed. We are changing the way that new-to-market products get discovered and shared. We use technology to level the playing field for the little guy. And then there are other things that are happening in our business. We coined the term citizen commerce because the truth is that the purchases that we make as consumers shape the world we live in. And we believe that consumers, of course, are very, very armed with information and knowledge these days. And informed consumers are seeking products that align with their own values. So one of the lenses that we use to choose products for our platform are the values represented by citizen commerce. That might be made in the United States. It might be a green or social venture. It might be job creation or sustainability. It might be a company that is led by an underrepresented entrepreneur. Might be fair trade, it might support local and small business. This is the kinds of stories that we're celebrating, and this is how we connect with consumers. And these are the faces of our Grommet makers. These are the people behind the product. As consumers or as a culture these days, we want to know where our food comes from, and we want to know where the products that we buy come from. We are curious and we celebrate the entrepreneurial journey that brings these products to market. That's our kind of playbook here. It's our firm belief that human connection between consumers and people behind the product is key. And we have found that today's consumers will root for you. That's the genesis of that opening slide, that there are people out there that say, I want to buy from small business. And so we celebrate that. We see that every day. Honestly, there's a trust that's built when you put a face to the company. And it's the simplest of transparencies. But today we find it to be very, very powerful, connecting consumer to the people behind the product is powerful. And so the lesson here is when you're creating your own kind of web presence, don't ever ignore that story, our story. Put your pictures in there. I don't care. Put your picture of your dog in there. It works because people want to understand that you're a great company. Don't be shy about telling people what you stand for as a business. In every business that you form, you have to have your secret sauce. Like, what is your business distinction? Every single conversation I enter into, I'm always thinking about what is it that's going to make Grommet stand out as being different than others. It's a tough world out there competitively, and you need to stand for something. And so I would share with you our secret sauce, and maybe you can apply some of this to your own strategies, but there's four simple things that we do at the very core of our every initiative that we launch and every decision that we make. And that is that we will celebrate the discovery of new, that we will focus on storytelling, not selling, and we will make human connections, that we will use video to demonstrate and create product understanding, and that we will always be mindful of people's time, and we will create bite-sized content that can be cast across the web to draw people to us. That's our secret sauce. One of the biggest questions, or most frequent questions I receive is, you know, how do you choose? You know, we can only we can't support everyone. So some of the basic evaluation criteria for us are, is the product innovative and is it from a small business? We've already established that. Is it unique and undiscovered? We only support physical products. We don't support software. If there's an app attached to the product, that's fine. There's a physical product at its core. And then, of course, we're focused on 16 consumer product categories. But there's a lot more that goes into it. You know, we're working with people who have no kind of breadcrumbs yet, often. There's no reviews. There's not a lot of presence online. So we have to vet the entrepreneur and the inventor. And the biggest question is, are you ready? We have 3 million people who we are going to launch your product to through newsletters and across the web. And do you have the foundational readiness to be launched in that way? You know, does the product do what it said it says it will do? How well is it branded and packaged? You know, what is your pricing? Is there a price value fit? In our catalog, is it strengthen our catalog, or is it something that's kind of me too to a lot of other products? These are the kinds of things you should be establishing. In our partnership, can we make the economics work? Everybody needs to kind of be fit into that economic equation. And as entrepreneurs, you need to make sure that you are factoring in all the help you're going to need along the way to be successful. And that's selling partners. It might be a wholesaler, or a distributor, or a retail partner. I know this is basic stuff for a lot of you guys, but I sometimes it's good to kind of just start at the foundation. The other thing that we look for are those values that we mentioned earlier. What does this company stand for? How can we that helps our stories telling, and it helps us connect to people. So we're going to kind of tag you, and we're going to talk about your product and your brand and your company and you based on that lens of kind of social value. Your branding, how good is it? Do you explain your product well? Is it catchy and compelling? Does it look contemporary? Does it look old? Invest in design help if you need it. It's important. And then always it comes down to the story. Again, we are storytellers. That's how we think. We're not sellers. We're storytellers. I always tell the team when they're creating media, don't sell, tell. If I strip out selling language out of every story I can, because I think people don't trust it. And so that is where it starts. I'm going to show you how we bring a simple toy like this to life. First of all, these guys light up. And I expect that this entrepreneur is going to improve his branding and his or her branding or packaging as time goes on. But what I want to show you is how we take this product which might get ignored on shelves in its early days before it has that word of mouth and how we bring it to life. And that's how we do it. And so, I'm going to encourage you all to, when you're ready, be ready. And we can talk this weekend about your readiness. Submit your product to us for consideration. If we choose you, if we think you're ready, and we think we can do a good job for you, we will do a good job for you. So on the footer of our homepage, there is a place that says Become a Grommet. It's a short form. We'll research you and we'll get back to you. And then finally, we wrote a book. I didn't write a book. My partner, CEO of Grommet, wrote a book. She's a much better writer than I am. And last week it was named by Inc. Magazine, one of the top 11, I don't know why 11, maybe we were the 11th, book. For entrepreneurs, business books for entrepreneurs. The name of the book is How We Make Stuff Now, and it's a playbook for inventors. It's inexpensive and it's practical, it's no nonsense, and it kind of, it chapter by chapter, talks about the things that we've learned in our 11 years. Thank you for being patient with me. And I'm here all weekend. Please find me. I'd love to speak with you.